In this video, I'm going to show you how to program the SCUT KMT touchscreen controller. Hi, Marie here, back with another informative Kiln video for you. Whether you're new to using kilns or not, this touchscreen controller makes running the kiln a breeze. With advanced programming for when you become a pro and guided program for the beginner. I'm going to go through the guided start for the beginners. Let's begin. Begin here. Program. Guided start. What are you firing? Select ceramics and press next if you want to perform a simple bisque or glaze firing. Next. Bisque, glaze, or preheat only. Choose bisque and press next if you have clay that is dry but not yet fired. Next. Do you want to preheat? Choose none and press next if you're confident that your wares are completely dry and there are no pieces larger than 12 inches and thicker than 1/4 inch. Next. Choose your cone value recommended by the clay manufacturer for bisque and press next. I do 0.4. Choose a speed. Choose slow for most bisque fires and press next. This will take approximately 12 hours. Let's see what medium has to say. Choose medium if you don't have time for a slow firing and press next. This will take approximately 7.5 hours. We strongly recommend using the slow speed for bisque firing whenever possible. Okay, we'll go to slow then. And next. Press next to review your program and start the firing. Wow, that was easy. Now you can review everything here, and if you want to change anything, it's as simple as pressing the arrow. Let's say we want to add a preheat time. I'm not sure that my wares are dry enough, so I'm going to throw in a 2-hour preheat time. 2 hours and hit save. Now the preheat is going to climb 60 degrees every hour until it reaches 180 degrees. That means that once it gets to 180 degrees, then it will preheat for 2 hours. So keep that in mind. We're all set. Now hit start. The great part is you can hit stop anytime and go back, look at your program, go to program, then go to cone fire, and let's say you don't want to preheat, you change your mind. Just hit the arrow, 000, and save. Now you can start over again. It's that easy. Now we're going to do a glaze firing. Begin here. Program, guided start, ceramics, glaze. Choose glaze and press next if your bisque firing has been completed and you want to glaze fire. Choose the cone value recommended by the glaze manufacturer and press next. Be sure not to mix up the cone 6 with cone 06. I love the prompts they have here for the beginners. It's wonderful. We're going to do other. Next, move my toggle to cone 5 and hit next. Choose slow if you're glaze firing large pieces and press next. This will take approximately 12 hours. Let's see what medium has to say. Choose medium for most glaze firings and press next. This will take approximately 7.5 hours to fire. Press next and review your program and start the firing. No preheat, cone 5, speed medium. There's no hold or no delay. Let's say you want to do a hold. And actually, a 3 to 5 minute hold is good to equalize the temperature in the kiln or to allow the glaze to flow more on your pieces. Hit the arrow and hit 5 minutes and save. Now you have a 5 minute hold. Oh no, I want a 3 minute hold instead. Hit 3 and save. It's that easy. Then you can start your firing. Let's say you're familiar with the kiln and you no longer need the guided start. Begin here, program, cone fire, and I'm going to do a bisque fire. So I want cone 04. Move the toggle up to 04. Oops. Save. I want slow speed. Save. Hold time? No, I don't need a hold time for bisque. Save. I want to do a preheat though. Let's do a 2 hour preheat. Save. Now you're all set for your bisque fire and just press start. I love how the controller guides you through the programming until you learn more about the firing process. Another great plus is the built-in Wi-Fi, which allows you to monitor the status and temperature from your smartphone. Upgrade the firmware and give the SCUT technicians access to your controller to help you with any troubleshooting. To find more helpful information about kilns, don't forget to check out Pottery Crafter's website. When you like, subscribe, and watch other videos, you support this channel and help me to make more videos like this one. Head on over to this kiln loading video or Ultimate Edger video. If you do, I get to play with more clay. Let's stay dirty.